गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर रिज्यूमिंग आवर चैप्टर फ्रॉम पेज नंबर 22। अनलाइक द डेथ रेट एंड बर्थ रेट हैज नॉट रजिस्टर्ड अ शार्प फॉल, दिस इज बिकॉज द बर्थ रेट इज सोशो कल्चरल फिनोमेन दैट इज रिलेटेड स्लोली टू चेंज। By and large, increased level of prosperity exert a strong downward pull on the birth rate. Once infant mortality rate declines, there is an overall increase in the level of education and awareness. Family size begin to fall. There are very wide varieties in fertility rate across the state of India, as can be seen in chart 2. Some states like Kerala and Tamil Nadu have managed to bring down their total fertility rate to 1.7 each in 2009. This means that the average women in Kerala and Tamil Nadu produce only 1.7 children, which is the below replacement level. And Kerala's TFR is also below the replacement level, which means that the population is going to decline in future. Many other states like Himachal Pradesh, West Bengal, Karnataka and Maharashtra have fairly low TFRs. But there are some states, notably Bihar, Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan, Uttar Pradesh, which are still high at TFRs. In 2009, the TFRs of these states were 3.9, 3.3, 3.3 and 3.7 respectively. According to SRS Bulletin in 2015, India's total birth rate is 22.4, among them rural birth rate is 22.4 and urban 17.3. The highest birth rate in India of Uttar Pradesh 26.7 and Bihar 26.3. And they will also account for about half, 50% of the addition of the Indian population up to the year 2026. Uttar Pradesh alone is expected to count for a less than one quarter, 22% of this increase. Chart 3 shows the relative contribution of population growth from different regional groupings of states. Kerala and Tamil Nadu are having stabilized death and birth rates as they are having good literacy level. UP is having high replacement level, that is 4:1. Low fertility rate is in Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, Himachal Pradesh, West Bengal, Kerala, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh. This is because most of the northern states desire to have a male child. And this is the reason they are having low fertility rate. NREGA, that means National Rural Employment Guarantee Act, takes care to see that everyone is employed so that if there is a famine, they can move somewhere else and buy food. Total fertility rate is when the birth rate is high and death rate is low. It results in population explosion. In India, birth rate is still high because of mindset of people, desire for male child and patrilineal society. Students, on page number 22, 2.3, age structure of the Indian population. India has a very youth population, that is the majority of Indians tend to be young and the average age is also less than that for the most other countries. Table 2 shows that the share of the under 15 age group in the total population has come down for its higher level of 42% in 1971 to 35% in 2001. The share of the 15 to 60 age group has increased slightly from 53% to 59%. While the share of 60 plus age group is very small, but it has begun to increase from 5% to 7% over the same period. But the age composition of Indian population is expected to change significantly in the next two decades. Most of this change will be at the two ends of the age spectrum, as table 2 shows the 0 to 14 age groups will reduce its share by about 11%. From 34% in 2001 to 23% in 2006, while 60 plus age group will increase its share by adult 5% from 7% in 2001 and about 12% in 2026. Chart 4 shows a graphical picture of the population pyramid from 1961 to its project shape in 2016. Students, on page number 22, table 2, it is telling us about the composition of the population of India, that is from 1961 to 2026. It is giving us an estimation percentage of the people falling in the all three age groups. This table is based on the data from the Technical Group of Population Projection of the National Commission on Population. This table is telling us about the all three age groups from 1961 to 2026. In 1961, there were 41% of the youth population, 53% was the working population, and 6% was the dependent population. In 1991, there were 83% of the youth, 56% was the working, and 7% was the dependent population. And in 2026, 64% will be the working population, dependent population will be 12%, and youth will be 23%. Demographic dividend is the working population is higher than the non-working population. So working population is the age group falling from 15 to 64 years, and the non-working population is also called as the dependent population, that is above 64 years. Kerala is having good age structure as there is increase in working population. Literacy rate is also very high as they are educated about the economic growth. Uttar Pradesh is also having good working population because of the large working youth population and decreased age group. Demographic dividend can be maintained by the better education and awareness. Students, on page number 25, go through the age group pyramid shown in chart 4. NREGA, that means National Rural Employment Guarantee Act, takes care to see that everyone is employed so that if there is a famine, they can move somewhere else. As with fertility rate, there are wide regional variations in the age groups as well. While the state like Kerala is beginning to acquire an age structure like that of developed countries, Uttar Pradesh present a very different picture of high proportions in the younger age groups and relatively low proportion among the aged. India as a whole is somewhere in the middle because it includes states like Uttar Pradesh as well, states like more like Kerala. Chart 5 shows the estimated population pyramids of Uttar Pradesh and Kerala in the year 2026. Note the difference in the location of the white part of the pyramid for Kerala and Uttar Pradesh. So students, these two pyramids are telling about the difference between Uttar Pradesh and Kerala in coming 2026. It says that Kerala has begun to acquire age structure like the developed countries and so as the Uttar Pradesh as well, because it is having higher young age and lower proportion of aged. Students, on page number 27, this paragraph means that demographic dividend is benefiting the India as working population is higher than the dependent ones. And this is because we are having 15 to 64 years of people in the greater level. And working age group must support itself as well, those outside the age group. That's all for today. Students, go through page number 27, box 23.